हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम अगेन ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल माइक्रोबायोलॉजी बाय संतोष नपते। आई एम असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर संतोष नपते, वर्किंग इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ माइक्रोबायोलॉजी, संभाजीराव केंद्रे महाविद्यालय, जळकोट। सो फ्रेंड्स, फ्रॉम लास्ट ईयर बिकॉज ऑफ दिस COVID-19 पैंडेमिक, वी हैव टू स्टार्ट दिस ऑनलाइन प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर टीचिंग बिकॉज ऑफ lockdown, and I have started this YouTube channel, so which consists of many videos on microbiology, including theoretical portion as well as videos on multiple choice question. So if you are not subscribed this microbiology by Santosh Napte, kindly subscribe this channel so that you will get notifications of upcoming videos. Friends, in today's lecture we will start this DNA repair mechanisms. In last lecture we have studied about the mechanism of induced mutations, and in that we have studied different types of mutagenic agents, that is physical mutagenic agents, chemical mutagenic agents and biological mutagenic agents. So all these agents, they causes the mutations in DNA molecule, or they causes mutations in these nucleic acids or in the nucleotide sequence. So there is one mechanism in cells to repair these mutations or to repair these DNA damages. So in today's lecture we will see about these DNA repair mechanisms, which are the different mechanisms and how that DNA damages can be repaired by the cells. Okay, so here we will see that repair of DNA by photoreactivation, then we will see nucleotide excision repair mechanism, then we will see base excision repair mechanism, and lastly we will see about mismatch excision repair mechanism. So one by one we are going to start here. So this is the outline of this point here or chapter, that is introduction, then sources of DNA damage, causes of DNA damage, and then we will see mechanism of DNA repairs. So actually in previous lectures we have already learned about the different types of mutations or how there is a damage to that DNA molecule takes place. So before that, going further, we will see what is meant by this DNA repair. So DNA repair, it is a collection of processes by which a cell identifies and corrects damages to the DNA molecules that encodes its genome. Now in human cell, that is both normal metabolic activities as well as environmental factors, for example ultraviolet light and the radiations, they can cause damage to the cell or damage to the DNA molecule, and it results in as many as 1 million individual molecular lesions per cell per day. So naturally that living cells, they get exposed to the ultraviolet light as well as radiations, and this ultraviolet light and radiation, they can cause damage to the DNA molecule, resulting into the molecular lesions per in cell per day, and that number, it is about 1 million molecular lesions. And many of these lesions or damages, they cause structural damage to the DNA molecule. So it affects the structure of that DNA molecule, and that's why can alter or can eliminate the ability of cells to transcribe that particular gene, and in this way it affected that genes or the DNA molecule. And if the transcription ability of that gene is affected, so definitely whatever that protein will be formed here, that will be non-functional protein, or it will, or it cannot do its normal function. And other lesions, they induces potentially harmful mutations in the cell's genome, which affect the survival of its daughter cells after it undergoes the mitosis. So that's why, so this DNA damages, it is causing very, or it is very harmful to the cell or to the individual, and that's why it is very essential to repair that DNA damages. So that we are going to see in this topic here. So that DNA repair process, it is constantly active in the cell and it responds to any damage in the DNA structure. So whatever the, during replication process or any normal processes, whatever that damage is takes place to the DNA molecule, that is identify the DNA repair mechanism, and that's why it is constantly working in the cells or in the body. When normal processes fail and when cellular apoptosis does not occur, apoptosis simply it is nothing but the that is death of the cells or periodic death of the cells. If this apoptosis does not occur, then irreparable DNA damage can occur in the cells, and that includes the double strand breaks as well as DNA cross linkages. And if the rate of DNA repair, it is dependent on many factors. For example, the cell type, the age of the cell, and the extracellular environment. So these are the DNA damages. Already we have seen in previous lectures, that is the DNA mutations, which are the different types of mutation and how that DNA damage takes place here. So in short, I am going to explain here that because our main point is here, repair mechanisms. So which are the sources of DNA damages? So that DNA damage is divided into two main types. One is endogenous damage, that is attack by reactive oxygen species produced from normal metabolic byproducts because of spontaneous mutation, and especially the process of oxidative deamination that we have seen in the mutation, and it also includes the replication errors. So these are the endogenous damages which occur in the DNA molecule. Exogenous damages includes, these are caused by the external agents, for example ultraviolet light, that is radiations from the sun and having the wavelength of 200 to 400 nanometer, and other radiation frequencies, for example x-rays as well as gamma rays. Then plant toxins are also there which causes the exogenous damage, and there are some viruses, we can say these are the biological agents. Viruses are the biological agents which cause the mutations or which cause the damages. So all these agents, that may be the ultraviolet light, that may be the x-rays or gamma rays or plant toxins or chemical mutagenic agents or these viruses, these are not related to the cell or that individual. That's why these are called as exogenous damage. So these are the causes of damage. The main causes is the mutations and genomic instability that we all learn already. So these are the types of damages: oxidative damage, hydrolytic damage, and DNA strand breaks. So these are the main types or different types of the damages which takes place to the DNA molecule. So these are radiations or damages or mutations caused by radiations, and we have seen these radiations, specifically for example ultraviolet radiations, they cause the thymine dimers in the DNA molecule. So these radiations, they comes in three different forms: alpha, beta and gamma, and they damages DNA. So that's why cells work hard to repair it, and when we use it in medicine, for example in case of radiotherapy, so it acts by damaging DNA in cancer cells. So that is the basic principle behind the treatment of cancer or behind the killing of that cancerous cells, which is called as radiotherapy. So there is a use of these radiations, and these radiations, they attack on the cancerous cells and they damages the DNA of that cancerous cells. That's why ultimately that cancerous cells get killed. So these are the effect of these ultraviolet radiations on the DNA. There is a damage takes place. So this is the damage which is taking place by hydrolysis, then which involves, hydrolysis involves two steps: depurination and deamination. We have already learned in this mechanism of induced mutations or that types of mutations. So this is the DNA damage by oxidation. So this is the, see here, this is the diagram here, oxidative damage. So this oxidative damage, it causes the aging, or it results into the, or it affect on DNA, protein as well as lipids. So this is the basic of different types of DNA damages, and that we have introduced about the DNA repair mechanism. Now actually we are going to start here mechanisms of DNA repair, which are the different mechanisms here that we are going to see here. Now one is the direct reversal repair. So in many cases or most cases of DNA damage, these are not reversible. That means they are permanent damage. For cases which are reversible, our body uses the direct reversal repair mechanism to correct that damaged bases or damaged DNA molecule. So our body or cells has the normal mechanism which involves the damage repair of this damaged DNA molecule or that damaged bases. And this is one of the important mechanism which is called as the direct reversal repair mechanism. So how this direct reversal repair occurs in the body or in the cell, or how that damaged DNA molecules get repaired by using this mechanism. So this direct reversal repair, it is a mechanism of repair where the damaged area or the lesion, it is repaired directly by a specialized proteins in our body. And it is the simplest form of DNA repair mechanism and also the most energy efficient method. Okay, so it does not require a reference template unlike other single stranded repair mechanism. So this is the simplest mechanism of DNA repair, which is called as direct reversal repair. So this is the example here. This is 3-methyl cytosine. Then this proteins or now later on this nucleotide is or a base is formed here, and finally removal of HCHO, it results into the normal base, that is the cytosine. Means if there is a introduction of this methyl cytosine during replication process, for example, so our direct reversal repair mechanism, it removes this 3-methyl cytosine in this way, and it replaces with cytosine, which is a normal nucleotide or normal nitrogen base. Second one is excision repair mechanism. So most such damaged products involve neither pyrimidine dimers nor ortho-6-alkyl guanine. So they must be handled by a different mechanism. Many cases there is no pyrimidine or thymine dimers are there, or nor there is ortho-6-alkyl guanine is there. So in there is other damages are there. So in such cases, this repair can be done by the other mechanism. And most of such damages, these are removed by a process called as excision repair. So this damaged DNA is first removed and then it is replaced with the fresh DNA molecule. So in this excision repair mechanism, what is the main principle here? That damaged DNA is first removed and then it is replaced with the fresh DNA or fresh nucleotide. So this is the mechanism of that is excision repair here. The damaged DNA is first removed and then it is replaced with fresh DNA or nucleotide by one or different mechanisms. One is base excision repair, nucleotide excision repair, mismatch repair, double stranded break repair, or recombinant repair. So these are the different mechanisms of base excision or excision repair. So that we will see here. One is base excision repair. So base excision repair, it is more prevalent and it usually works on common relatively subtle changes to DNA bases such as chemical modifications which are caused by the cellular agents. So whatever that modifications or damages are caused by the chemicals, so that modifications, that changes can be repaired, or that damages can be repaired by this base excision repair mechanism. So how this base excision repair mechanism works, or how it replaces that damaged DNA molecules, or how it repair that damaged DNA. So this process, it begins with the DNA glycosylase enzyme, which extrudes a base in a damaged base pair, then clips out the damaged base. So this is the main enzyme here, that is called as DNA glycosylase, that extrudes this base in a damaged base pair and it clips out that damaged base or nucleotide, then leaving an apyrenic or apyrimidinic site that attracts the DNA repair enzymes that removes the remaining deoxyribose phosphate and replaces it with the normal nucleotide. So in bacteria, the DNA polymerase 1, it is the enzyme that fills in the missing nucleotide in base excision repair. So that DNA polymerase, it is also a repairing enzyme in bacteria, DNA polymerase 1. And in eukaryotic cells, that DNA polymerase B, it it does this base oxygen repair mechanism. Okay, however, these enzymes make mistakes and it has no proofreading activity. So sometimes there is a mistakes will be done by these enzymes, but there is no proofreading activity. So this is the base oxygen repair mechanism in E. coli. So here, this is DNA. So this is the DNA molecule here. So that DNA glycosylase extrudes the damaged DNA base. So this enzyme, it extrudes this damaged DNA base. This is the damaged DNA base here at this position, this red color. Then in second step, that DNA glycosylase removes the extruded base, leaving an apurinic or apyrimidinic site on the bottom DNA strand. See here, then this DNA glycosylase, it removes this damaged nucleotide here. So there it is removed, and this is the AP site, that is apurinic site, or that is called as apyrimidinic site. Then this an apyrimidic endonuclease cuts the DNA on the 5' side or the AP site. See here, there is a cutting of this DNA by this AP endonucleases enzymes. Then in next step, this DNA phosphodiesterase removes the AP deoxyribose phosphate, that is yellow block here, this one, and then that was left by the DNA glycosylase. See here, this DNA glycosylase enzyme removes that nucleotide, damaged nucleotide here, so it is shown here red color, and this AP endonucleotide that nucleus, it caused the break in this DNA strand. And in next step, that DNA phosphodiesterase, it removes the short block of that DNA molecule here. So it is shown here. And then in last steps, that DNA polymerase 1. So DNA polymerase 1, it fills the gap and continues the repair synthesis for a few nucleotides downstream. Now whatever the gap is formed here, and that gap, it is because of the absence of some nucleotides. So that nucleotides or that gap, it is filled by the DNA polymerase 1. And finally, that DNA ligase seals the nick left by the DNA polymerase. So after addition of that nucleotides by this DNA polymerase 1, so there is a missing of that phosphodiester linkage. And that phosphodiester linkage, or which is called as a nick, actually there is an absence of this phosphodiester bond. So that nick, that bond, it is formed by the DNA ligase enzyme. And finally, this is the repaired DNA molecule. So this is the repaired DNA molecule. So this is called as base oxygen repair. Second one is here, nucleotide oxygen repair mechanism. So this nucleotide oxygen repair, it generally deals with more drastic changes to the bases, and many of which distort the DNA double helix. The changes tend to be caused by mutagenic agents from outside of the cell. An example is here, formation of pyrimidine dimer caused due to the ultraviolet light. Or we can say these are the thymine-thymine dimers. So that we will see how this nucleotide oxygen repair mechanism repairs that thymine-thymine dimers. So this nucleotide oxygen repair, it handles bulky damage that distorts the DNA double helix. And this NER, or nucleotide oxygen repair in E. coli, it begins when that damaged DNA is clipped by an endonuclease on either side of the lesions at sites of 12 to 13 apart. And this allows the damaged DNA to be removed as part of the resulting 12 to 13 base oligonucleotide. And finally, that DNA polymerase 1 fills the gap and DNA ligase seals the final nick, or it forms the phosphodiester linkage. So in this way, that nucleotide oxygen repair mechanism correct or repair that damaged DNA molecule. See, this is the diagram of nucleotide oxygen repair in E. coli. So here, this is the formation of thymine-thymine dimer here. So this EVR ABC exonuclease cuts on either side of damaged DNA, that is red, and this causes the removal of that damaged nucleotide or DNA here. Then in second step, that oligonucleotide 12 nucleotide long, if the damage were a pyrimidine dimer, then the oligonucleotide would be a 13 mer instead of a 12 mer. If it is DNA, that is thymine, thymine dimer, and then that DNA polymerase 1 fills the missing nucleotides at that position using this top strand or above strand as a template strand, and then that DNA ligase enzyme fills the nick, or it forms the, that is, phosphodiester linkage. So finally there is a repaired DNA molecule is formed. See, this is the damaged DNA molecule here, and this is the repaired DNA molecule. Next one is here, mismatch repair. So this mismatch repair, it deals with the correcting mismatches of normal bases, and that is failures to maintain normal Watson-Crick base pairing. The normal Watson-Crick base pairing is adenine pairs with thymine or vice versa, or guanine pairs with cytosine or vice versa. So if there is a pairing apart from this, that is the mismatch pairing, then recognition of this mismatch pairing is done by this repair mechanism, and it is repaired. So but this recognition of a mismatch repair, that nucleotides, it requires several different proteins. So double stranded break repair, that two methods for repairing this double strand break, one is by homologous recombination and another one is by non-homologous ending joints. So this is not the part of our syllabus here. So we have seen these different mechanisms. Then remaining portion, one mechanism is here, that is of photoreactivation. Actually we have seen that photoreactivation also. So here we have finished these DNA repair mechanisms. So that photoreactivation, or in next lecture we will say that photoreactivation. So if you have not subscribed this Microbiology by Santosh Napte, so kindly subscribe this channel. Thank you.